Hey nerds, welcome to another episode of Breaking the Source Wall. With the new Loki series starting up, I figured it'd be a pretty decent idea to talk about the funny fake dying man himself, so let's get right into it. Marvel's Loki Laufeyson first appeared in Journey into the Mystery number 85 back in October of 1962. He was created by the legendary writer Stan Lee and artists Jack Kirby and Larry Lieber. Listen, if you want to get really tactical with it, he first appeared in Venus number 6 back in August of 1949. That wasn't the incarnation of Loki that we know now, so I don't really count it as being him. I'm actually not going to talk about Loki's first debut at all here because I'm planning a whole video on it. It's such a strange and fun issue that I couldn't pass up talking about it. Make sure you subscribe because trust me, you're not going to want to miss this. Also, maybe drop a like. That'd be pretty cool. Anywho, self-promotion out of the way, Loki in the Marvel Comics 616 universe is the adopted brother of Thor, the god of thunder. As his name implies, Loki Laufeyson is the son of Laufey. Go figure. King Laufey of Jotunheim was the king of the Frost Giants. When Loki was born, he was hidden and outcast from the Frost Giants, as his stature was stunted, because giants don't really consider human-sized giants to be giants because, well, they aren't really giant. After Loki got the Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer treatment for a bit, Odin, King of Asgard, killed King Laufey for a completely different reason. Odin eventually found the kid of the guy he killed and was like, "Hey, this is awkward. Do you want to be my kid? Instead, maybe?" And it worked! He snagged baby Loki and made him his adopted child. Everything was good. Until Loki and Odin arrived at the palace and Odin immediately favored his son Thor over Loki. Loki didn't really like this at all, so he used his innate magical abilities to play haha funny pranks on Thor to troll him a bit, and eventually, things escalated a little bit, and he went from being a funny meme man to wanting to kill his brother in cold blood. Now let's go over Loki's powers, because the god of mischief has quite a bit up his sleeve. Loki has superhuman strength and durability, as well as an extended lifespan due to his frost giant blood, with a vast assortment of abilities due to his innate sorcery, including, but not limited to, flight, illusion casting, teleportation, hypnosis, shapeshifting, and energy blast. And that's not even all of it. Calling the dude a formidable threat would be an understatement. In fact, Loki was the reason the Avengers were formed in the first place. That's right, just like in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, the funny dying man was the threat that formed Marvel's famous boy band in the comics as well. There was also a point where Loki became a goth GF for a bit. I could give you context, but I'm not going to. After getting his old body back, he immediately got ripped to shreds by Sentry's evil void persona. Gotta love a nice spawn kill. Speaking of spawn, Loki respawned as a small child with no memories of his not-so-nice past deeds of his former life, but with all the same powers and actually became a hero that probably liked Fortnite. This is where things get a bit confusing. Kid Loki eventually found that an echo of the previous Loki was inside him that he decided to dub Eichel, which is Loki backwards as he thought Eichel was his opposite. Eichel convinced Kid Loki that he wanted to change and be a better person, but Loki didn't fully buy it at first. So he did what any logical person would do, obviously. Instead of making him into a person, he turned him into a bird. I mean, he definitely thought outside the box. Kid Loki adventured with Eichel as his guide, which made for some really cool art of the two. Eventually, it was revealed that Eichel was never a real bird, but only existed within Kid Loki's mind, and that Eichel had deceived Loki and only wanted control over his body. This truly shocks me. I never would have thought the god of mischief would ever deceive a child. Eichel took control over Kid Loki's body, becoming Loki once again and killing the consciousness of Kid Loki in the process, achieving a true mental victory royale. Or so it seemed. Apparently, Kid Loki's spirit remained as an echo within Loki that haunted him. Really, the turntables. Loki later stole the power of Wiccan, the heroic son of Scarlet Witch, and left him to die. But Kid Loki said, "Hey, you know, that's a bit messed up." And Loki was like, "Okay, maybe you're right." And he saved Wiccan and gave his powers back. After receiving the kind act of not being left to die completely, Wiccan also aged Loki up to his late teenage years at Loki's request so he could avoid puberty. That's not the real reason, but I like to think it is. From that point, Loki actually wanted to do good, and he became a hero. Eventually, he cast a spell to temporarily revive Kid Loki, who later joined the Asgardians of the Galaxy, and also died off again once the spell wore off. There was that one time Loki ran for president. He lost to the whole trying to rule the world thing, but hey! The Loki series is actually using this as source material, so that's pretty neat. Loki's kept up his good boy points in the comics. He was a key player of the heroes in the Infinity Wars event, and a few years ago, he even became Sorcerer Supreme. This was a bit of a cool arc for his character. Not as cool as when Doctor Doom became Iron Man, because that was absolutely amazing, but still, it was pretty neat. After that, he lifted the Hammer of Thor and became worthy, cementing the fact that he changed as a character. He went from being the god of lies and mischief to being the god of stories as he moved on from that life. And on that note, I think we should wrap it up. Thank you so much for watching. If you made it this far, drop TVA in the comment section, as well as what you want to see explained from Nerd Media next. And I will personally heart your comment if I see it. It's the highest honor I can bestow. If you're new to the channel, glad to have you. Be sure to drop a like, subscribe, and hit the little bell icon to be notified whenever I upload a video. It really goes a long way for newer content creators like myself. And I think that'll do it. Peace, true believers.